Hello guys, welcome to my third class of Laplace transform. Before moving to the next step, we are going to consider some few properties based on Laplace transform. The first one of the property and also very much useful ever in a quite solidly problem, commonly linear property. Linear property is nothing but whenever this property is very much useful, whenever they having the function more than one term, maybe somewhat difference more than one term, maybe two terms or three terms. If you want to find out Laplace transform of entire function, entire sum of the term, better to take Laplace transform of the sum. For example, Laplace transform of a into f of x plus r minus b into g of x, where a and b are some constant. Now, instead of taking entire function, that can also be written as a into Laplace transform of f of x plus r minus b into Laplace transform of g of x. This is a one of important property when solving a problem. That property is called linear property. Now this linear property is very much useful whenever having more than one function, more than one term in the finding the Laplace transform. The next property is shifting property. This property also very important when solving a problem. In the shifting property, if Laplace transform of f of x is equal to capital F of s, we already discussed in previous class, then Laplace transform of product of exponential into any function, this function may be any trigonometry, whatever may be, that is nothing but capital F of s minus a. Means, first you find out Laplace transform of f of x. Once you get Laplace transform f of x and then replace s by s minus of the coefficient of x in exponential. Now, instead of taking entire function e power of x into f of x to apply the Laplace transform, we get very complicated function. Now, suppose you apply shifting property, not necessary to find out entire function. Other than exponential, you take it and then you find out Laplace transform and then replace s by s minus of the quotient of x in exponential. Now, using this property, the very complicated function easily have to solve. The next is change of scale property. Change of scale property. Now, while change of scale property, now, again, if Laplace transform of f of x is capital F of s, then Laplace transform of f of ax, product of that, is nothing but f of s by a. Means, you take other than a, find out Laplace transform. After once you get Laplace transform, replace s by the quotient of x in f. This we are not going to use change of scale property, rarely we are going to use. But first two things are very important. The question is arise, why you consider the property in the Laplace transform? Why don't you find out directly Laplace transform of the given function? Now I told you, suppose you apply this function whenever having more than one term, directly apply the definition of Laplace transform is possible, I to find out, but it's very tedious, very lengthy. Instead of that, you are applying this linear property, we get very easily. But both the answer must be same. The next shifting property also. Whenever having product of exponential into any function, not necessary to take entire function to apply the Laplace transform. Just leave it to the exponential function. You take remaining function, you find out Laplace, and then replace s by s minus of the quotient of x in exponential. Therefore, because of that, we are studying properties. Anyone who come and ask, why you need to study for properties, means you have to give one answer is, now all the problem is not possible to solve very comfortably, very easily for the function. In such case, if you want to overcome that, we are going to adopt some properties or nothing but linear property, change of scale property. Why you have to adopt? From this property, it's easy to evaluate the function Laplace transform Laplace transform. Therefore, we are using these properties. That's why you are learning these properties. The based on this property, I am going to take one of the functions, say Laplace transform of cos hyperbolic AT, and also I need to find out Laplace transform of sin alpha by AT. Yeah, if you want to find out this, anyway we already discussed in the previous class, you know what's Laplace transform constant, what's the Laplace transform exponential. In the fundamental thing, in pure level, you already know that how to express hyperbolic function in terms of exponential. Now, for example, I want to find out Laplace transform of sin hyperbolic x or a t, whatever may be. Now, sin hyperbolic t. Now, first, I can express the sin of hyperbolic in terms of exponential, say, e power of a t minus of e power of minus a t divided by 2. Now, after once you express hyperbolic in terms of exponential, we get two terms. Instead of applying directly Laplace transform, I go for which property now? Linear property. Once you use linear property, we get very simple way term, Lippert transform. From the linear property, 1 by 2 into Laplace transform of e power of at minus 1 by 2 into Laplace transform of what? E power of minus at. From which property now? Linear property. You have a name of the property, just you mention that property, which property we are using in corresponding to the step. In the next, we just know we derived in the previous class, we know that Laplace transform of e power of a is, what is that? 1 by s minus a. Therefore, from this 1 by 2, what we get? 1 by s minus a. And then what we get? Actually 1 by 2 into 1 by s plus a, because instead of a, what you have? Minus. We get minus of minus plus. Suppose you confuse, you write it minus of minus a, what we get? Actually plus. Now, what's a common factor from these two terms? 1 by 2. Take LCM. What's LCM now? S minus a into s plus a is minus a. What we get in the numerator? S plus a minus a s minus a. Now, once you remove the bracket, plus s minus s cancel, a plus a, what we get? 2a. 2 cancel. What's the remainder? A divided by s square minus a square. This is nothing but Laplace transform of sin hyperbolic at. Similarly, express cos hyperbolic at in terms of exponential, only one changes, instead of minus what we get, plus final answer similarly we get s by s square plus a square. I am going to leave this part for the viewer yeah, to solve, because just only one the hint, what is cos hyperbolic at? Cos hyperbolic at is nothing but e power of at plus e power of minus at divided by 2. Apply the same steps, finally we get this answer. So, a square minus a square. Yeah. Observe carefully hyperbolic and sin at. Laplace transform whatever the sin at is nothing but a by a square plus a square. But here minus. This is the difference between hyperbolic to trigonometric function. The same formula. Here we get minus, here we get plus. Similarly, cos hyperbolic this. Similarly, you already studied in previous class. Cos AT is nothing but S divided by S square plus B square. These are the formulas are very, very important when solving a problems. We are treated these are the standard function. Finally, I consider another one function, say Laplace transform of e power of n. Now, I am not going to derive this one. Just by you apply definition of Laplace transform and then by using mathematical induction, you prove that result is true for n is equal to 0, n is equal to 1, etc. Next, you have to assume that result is true for n is equal to k. Then you have to show that result is true for n is equal to k plus 1. Therefore, I am not going to derive from the code. Just prove, just apply the definition of Laplace transform and then you prove by using mathematical induction. Everyone you know what's a mathematical induction proof. Just now I told you, first you have to verify that result is 2 pi n is 0, n is 1, etc. Now once you learn that, we get finally n factorial divided by s to the power of n plus 1. The case is n is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 is an integer. It's not an integer. This may be a fraction, then gamma of n plus 1 divided by s to the power of n plus 1 otherwise. We are going to take suitable formula based on the value of n. N is an integer, you go for this. N is not an integer, then we are going to take gamma of n plus 1 divided by x to the power of n plus 1. Because gamma of n plus 1 must be equal to n factorial. Yeah, these are the things we are considered now. Now, in the next thing, we are going to solve some problems based on what we discussed in the previous class and today's class. We discuss again, I am going to repeat, Laplace transform of 1, Laplace transform of e power of 80, Laplace transform of sin 80, cos 80, sin hyperbolic 80 and cos hyperbolic 80, and also Laplace transform of t power of n. This function is called ramp function. They are going to use the ramp function like that during your course subject. Okay, now I am going to take some problems based on that, how to solve in my next class. Thank you very much for listening my talk. Okay.